So hello everyone and welcome back once again to another revision session of the government schemes. Guys, today's session is not live due to certain technical faults in our office. So that's why the session is being, the session was recorded and presented to you now. But if you guys would have any doubt, then feel free to ask in the comment section. Agar koi bhi doubt honge, toh aap comment section mein pooch sakte hain. I will definitely reply to all those doubts. Alright. And in today's session, guys, we are going to do the schemes from Ministry of Power, New and Renewable Energy, Ministry of Food Processing Industry, Ministry of Fisheries, Tourism and Environment, Forest and Climate Change. Now, don't worry if you haven't revised the schemes from these ministries. Koi problem nahi hai because the schemes are very, very easy. Bahut easy schemes hai in ministries ki. But yes, they are equally important. Alright. So, without any delay, let's begin with the very first question. But before we begin, if you want to ace the exam this year, join this crash course which we have launched for this year's exam. And if you want to enroll in this course, you can download the app where you can get everything related to examination. And if you want to ask anything related to examinations, please follow me on Instagram. This is my Instagram ID. And now let's talk about question number 251 to 253, for which there is a passage. And today we are going to complete 300 questions. Aaj 300 questions complete ho jayenge hamare. And uske baad jo next session hoga, in which we are going to do 301 to 350 questions, I will take schemes from random ministries. ठीक है, मैं कहीं से भी कुछ भी उठा के डालूंगा because after completing today's session, most of the schemes have been covered. ज़्यादातर scheme जो है आज के session के बाद cover हो जाएंगी. उसके बाद जो है जो बची हुई schemes होंगी उसको हम cover करेंगे next 50 questions में. And in the next 50, that is from 350 to 400, I am going to cover the schemes from March onwards. जो March onwards से scheme है हम उसको cover करेंगे because that is also important for your exam. Alright. So to ensure the last mile connectivity and electricity connection to all the unelectrified households, once again guys, yes, so to ensure last mile connectivity and electricity connection to all the unelectrified households in the country and to provide solar photovoltaic based standalone systems for unelectrified households located in remote and inaccessible areas where grid extension is not possible, a scheme was launched by Ministry of Power. The ultimate objective of the scheme is to achieve universal household electrification. There are 5 automatic inclusion criteria and 14 automatic exclusion criteria. So I believe, guys, you have easily identified the name of this scheme. The scheme is Pradhan Mantri Saubhagya Yojana. Pradhan Mantri Saubhagya Yojana, which is Sahaj Pradhan Mantri Sahaj Bijli Har Ghar Yojana. Alright. And the objective of this scheme is to achieve the universal household electrification. Now, talking about the question number 251, which of the following is the nodal implementing agency for the scheme? Remember, it is being implemented by Ministry of Power, but and this ministry is headed by Mr. R.K. Singh, and his Lok Sabha constituency is Ara, which is in Bihar, of course. And remember, the nodal implementing agency for this scheme is REC, which is Rural Electrification Corporation. Option C will be the correct answer. Question 252 पे आ जाते हैं. The scheme mentioned in the passage was launched in which year? Very easy question. The scheme was launched in the year 2017. Option B will be the correct answer, guys, to this question. So these are very easy questions. I will not spare more time on these questions. All right. Question 253, for households which are not eligible under the scheme, how much amount is charged as one-time fee? Very, very important question. This question can be asked in your exam. अगर कोई हाउस होल्ड एलिजिबल नहीं है तो उसको कितना चार्ज देना पड़ेगा फॉर इलेक्ट्रिफिकेशन इन हिज और हर हाउस. ठीक है, सो फॉर दैट टाइप ऑफ बेनिफिशियरी ₹500 इज चार्ज्ड एज वन टाइम फी. ऑलराइट, ऑप्शन डी विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर गाइस टू दिस क्वेश्चन. मूविंग अहेड एंड इन द लास्ट क्वेश्चन, लेट मी टेल यू द टोटल आउटले फॉर दिस स्कीम इज 16,320 करोड़. ठीक है, 16,320 करोड़ इज द टोटल आउटले फॉर दिस स्कीम. 254 पे चलते हैं. टू प्रमोट द एफिशिएंट यूज ऑफ एनर्जी एट रेजिडेंशियल लेवल, एनहांसिंग द अवेयरनेस ऑफ कंज्यूमर्स अबाउट द एफिकेसी ऑफ यूजिंग एनर्जी एफिशिएंट अप्लायंसेस, अ स्कीम वाज लॉन्च्ड इन 2015 बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ पावर. अगेन अंडर द स्कीम एलईडीज आर बीइंग प्रोवाइडेड टू एवरी डोमेस्टिक हाउस होल्ड हैविंग मीटर्ड कनेक्शन एट एन अफोर्डेबल प्राइस ऑफ ₹70 पर एलईडी. ओके, लेट मी टेल यू द प्राइस एज वेल. यू जस्ट हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द स्कीम. ठीक है, इट वॉज लॉन्च्ड इन 2015 बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ पावर. Everything is already given. You just have to identify the name of the scheme. It is Unnat Jyoti by Affordable LEDs for All. Unnat Jyoti by Affordable LEDs for All is the name of the scheme. And that's why the correct answer will be what? Option A, Ujala Yojana. Remember, it is being implemented by Energy Efficiency Services Limited, which works under the Ministry of Power. All right. 255. Which of the following is the implementing agency for a scheme which was launched in 2015 for replacing conventional streetlights with smart and energy efficient LED streetlights across the country? Now remember, the target was to replace 3.5 crores conventional streetlights with smart and energy efficient LED streetlights. And the name of the scheme is Streetlight National Program. And of course, the implementing agency is Energy Efficient Services Limited. Option E will be the correct answer. 256, 257, there is a passage, you can say just three lines are there. Read the following passage. So it is a scheme launched by Ministry of Power R.K. Singh from Ara in Bihar. ठीक है, सो वेरी यू नो ये जो हिंट है सबसे बड़ा है इस स्कीम के लिए, यहीं से आपको क्लियर हो जाएगा, बिकॉज इट वॉज लॉन्च रिसेंटली इन द ईयर 2021. अंडर द स्कीम एलईडी बल्ब्स आर डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड टू रूरल हाउस होल्ड एट एन अफोर्डेबल कॉस्ट ऑफ जस्ट रुपीज टेन पे एलईडीज इसमें दिए गए हैं. ऑलराइट, नाउ कैन यू आइडेंटिफाई द नेम ऑफ द स्कीम गाइज? यस, ऑप्शन सी, इट इज ग्राम उजाला योजना विच वॉज लॉन्च फ्रॉम आरा, विच इज द लोकसभा कंस्टिट्यूएंसी ऑफ मिस्टर आर के सिंह. Alright, Gram Ujala Yojana is the correct answer, guys, to this question. Launched in 2021, rupees 10 में इसमें LED दिया जाता है, and it is being implemented by CESL, which is Convergence Energy Service Limited, which is a wholly owned subsidiary of Energy Efficiency Services Limited. ठीक है, Convergence Energy Services Limited. Question number 257 is based on the same thing. Which of the following is the implementing agency for the scheme? It is CESL. Option C will be the correct answer, guys, to this question. 258 पे आ जाओ. आइडेंटिफाई द स्कीम विच वॉज लॉन्च इन 2015 बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ पावर फॉर ऑपरेशनल एंड फाइनेंशियल टर्न अराउंड ऑफ स्टेट ओन्ड पावर डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन कंपनीज डिस्कॉम्स. ठीक है, द स्कीम एम्स टू रिड्यूस द इंटरेस्ट बर्डन, रिड्यूस द कॉस्ट ऑफ पावर, रिड्यूस पावर लॉसेज इन डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन सेक्टर एंड इम्प्रूव ऑपरेशनल एफिशियंसी ऑफ डिस्कॉम्स. वेरी ईजी स्कीम गाइज, वेरी वेरी ईजी. इट इज उज्ज्वल डिस्कॉम्स अश्योरेंस योजना. Ujjwal Discoms Assurance Yojana. Option E, Uday, will be the correct answer, guys, to this question. It was launched for enhancing the efficiency of the distribution companies across the country and to support in their financial crunch. It was launched in 2015 by Ministry of Power. 259, name the app launched by Ministry of Power which empowers citizens by real-time information sharing on power supply. So you just have to name the app. It was launched for empowering citizens by providing them with real-time information on power supply. The name of the app is Urja Mitra. Option A will be the correct answer. Question number 260. Which of the following ministries has decided to set up national mission on use of biomass in coal-based thermal power plants? Now you might get confused between Ministry of New and Renewable Energy, Ministry of Power, and Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. But the correct answer to this question, guys, is Ministry of Power. Option B will be the correct answer to this question. And remember, it will be launched for a period of 5 years. This national mission on use of biomass in coal-based thermal power plants will be implemented for a period of 5 years. All right. 261, 262. Read the following passage and you have to answer the questions that follow. For increasing farmers' income, providing reliable source for irrigation and de-dieselize the farm sector, a scheme was launched in 2019. The scheme aims to add the solar and renewable energy capacity of 30.8 gigawatt by 2022. And there are three components of the scheme. Very easy question. And now please don't get confused. It is PM Kusum, which is being implemented by Ministry of New and Renewable Energy. ठीक है, किसान का नाम सुनते ही, farmer का नाम सुनते ही Ministry of Agriculture mark मत कर देना please. प्रधानमंत्री किसान ऊर्जा सुरक्षा एवं उत्थान महाअभियान. इट इज बीइंग इंप्लीमेंटेड बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ न्यू एंड रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी. ऑलराइट, एंड देयर आर थ्री कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ द स्कीम. वन इज डिसेंट्रलाइज्ड ग्राउंड माउंटेड ग्रिड कनेक्टेड रिन्यूएबल पावर प्लांट्स. हाउ मच कैपेसिटी? 10,000 मेगावाट. सो फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन द करेक्ट आंसर इज ऑप्शन बी, 10,000 मेगावाट. अदर देन दिस देयर विल बी एस्टैब्लिशमेंट ऑफ 20 लाख स्टैंड अलोन सोलर पावर्ड एग्री पंप्स. ऑलराइट, Stand alone solar powered agri pumps 20 lakh and 15 lakh ग्रिड कनेक्टेड एग्री पंप्स, ठीक है, 15 लाख ग्रिड कनेक्टेड एग्री पंप्स, ऑप्शन बी विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर हियर. एंड हाउ मच परसेंट सब्सिडी इज प्रोवाइडेड बाय सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट फॉर सोलराइजेशन ऑफ ग्रिड कनेक्टेड एग्रीकल्चरल पंप्स. सॉरी, रिमेंबर गाइज, देयर इज अ प्रोविजन ऑफ प्रोवाइडिंग सब्सिडी बाय सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट एज वेल एज द रिस्पेक्टिव स्टेट गवर्नमेंट्स, एंड बोथ सेंटर एंड स्टेट विल प्रोवाइड 30% सब्सिडी ईच एंड द रेस्ट 40% विल बी बोर्न बाय द फार्मर इटसेल्फ. एंड सो ऑप्शन सी, 30% विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन, बिकॉज दिस क्वेश्चन इज रिगार्डिंग सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट ओनली. ऑलराइट, क्वेश्चन 263, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स इज करेक्ट विद रिस्पेक्ट टू ग्रीन एनर्जी कॉरिडोर स्कीम फेज 2. नाउ रिमेंबर, दिस स्कीम इज बीइंग इंप्लीमेंटेड बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ न्यू एंड रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी. ऑलराइट, सो लेट्स रीड आउट द स्टेटमेंट, उसी में से निकालते हैं करेक्ट कौन सा है. सो इट इज बीइंग इंप्लीमेंटेड बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ न्यू एंड रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी एंड नॉट मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एनवायरमेंट फॉरेस्ट एंड क्लाइमेट चेंज. द स्कीम विल बी कंप्लीटेड टिल फाइनेंशियल ईयर 2026 एंड नॉट 2027. सेंट्रल फाइनेंशियल असिस्टेंट इज नॉट 50% ऑफ द प्रोजेक्ट कॉस्ट, इट इज 33% ऑफ द प्रोजेक्ट कॉस्ट. द प्रोजेक्ट्स अंडर द स्कीम विल बी डेवलप्ड इन 7 states. दिस इज एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट. एंड विच आर दीज 7 states बाय द वे? दीज आर तमिलनाडु, केरला, कर्नाटका, देन वी हैव गुजरात, देन वी हैव राजस्थान, एंड फाइनली वी हैव उत्तर प्रदेश एंड हिमाचल प्रदेश. सो दीज आर दी 7 states. In which the scheme will be implemented, Green Energy Corridor Phase 2. And its Phase 2 was launched in the year 2022, not 2021. So therefore, the correct answer will be what? Option D. 264-265. Again, there is a passage. So the government is implementing a scheme for setting up of 50 solar parks of aggregate capacity of 40,000 megawatt in the country. Okay? This is quite, ye jo scheme hai, it is not that famous scheme. It does not remain in news so many times. So, I believe कि आपको थोड़ा सा question difficult लगने वाला है, but let's see कि आप में से कितने लोग इसका answer सही करते हैं. These parks are meant to provide developed infrastructure to facilitate installation of solar power projects. Central financial assistance of up to ₹10 lakh for preparation of detailed project report and ₹20 lakh per megawatt or 30% of the project cost, whichever is lower. Is provided for development of such parks under this scheme. Now remember, this scheme was launched in 2014 by Ministry of, again, New and Renewable Energy. Okay, and the name of the scheme is Development of Solar Parks and Ultra Mega Solar Parks in the country. Okay, this is the name of the scheme. So, koi bahut special naam nahi hai. It is only Development of Solar Parks and Ultra Mega Solar Power Projects in the country. That is the name of the scheme. But remember, 50 solar parks will be established with an aggregate capacity of 40,000 megawatt. When it was launched in 2014, the target was to set up 25 solar parks. But the target was extended to 50 solar parks with aggregate capacity of 40,000 megawatt. Do remember this. Alright, and now let's come to the question. When was the scheme launched? So it was launched in the year 2014. Option E will be the correct answer. 265, you have to fill the gap given in the passage. Okay, so for preparation of detailed project reports, ₹25 lakh is being provided by the Ministry of New and Renewable Energy. Option E again will be the correct answer, 25 lakhs. 266 pe aa jate, which of the following statements is incorrect with respect to central financial assistance provided under rooftop solar program phase 2? Remember, the guidelines for this phase 2 were launched in the year 2019. And the target is to add 4,000 megawatt rooftop solar capacity. The target is what? 4,000 megawatt rooftop solar capacity addition. Alright. And now let's talk about the incorrect statement. Alright. So central financial assistance up to 40% of benchmark cost is provided up to 3 kilowatt capacity. Bilkul sahi baat hai. And beyond 3 kilowatt and up to 10 kilowatt, 20% of benchmark cost is provided. Ye bhi bilkul sahi hai. In case of RWAs, 20% of the project cost is provided as CFA. Again, it is also correct. And incentives are provided to DISCOMs from initial, not 25. It is 18 gigawatt. Alright, so this will be the correct answer to our question because that is the incorrect statement. 18 gigawatt tak, initially 18 gigawatt capacity tak, DISCOMs ko incentive diya jata hai. Moving ahead to 267. Which of the following ministries is implementing a scheme for setting up of 12 gigawatt grid connected solar PV power projects by central public under central public sector undertakings where domestic cells and modules. Under the scheme, funding is provided through viability gap funding. Now remember, the name of the scheme is just this only, CPSU scheme, and it is being implemented by Ministry of New and Renewable Energy. Option B will be the correct answer. And under this scheme, viability gap funding, the funding is provided through viability gap funding up to rupees 70 lakh per megawatt. 70 lakh per megawatt funding is provided through viability gap funding. All right. 268 to 270. It is a scheme for upgrading the micro food processing industry by providing financial, technical and business support. Very, very easy question this is. It is a centrally sponsored scheme launched for a duration of 5 years. For marketing and branding of FPIs, 50% of the cost is provided as the grant. Alright, let me give you some other hints as well. Credit linked capital subsidy is also provided up to 35% of the project cost. 35% of the project cost up to maximum rupees 10 lakh. Alright. And it was launched in the year 2020 up to 2024-25. 2024-25 period ke liye isko launch kiya gaya hai. Alright. And how much seed capital per SHG is provided under this scheme? And what is the name of the scheme, by the way? Alright. I forgot to tell you the name. It is Prime Minister Formalization of Micro Food Processing Industry Scheme. PM. Prime Minister Formalization of Micro Food Processing Industry Scheme is the name of the scheme. And rupees 40,000 per SHG is provided as the seed capital under this scheme. Option D will be the correct answer. And how many brands have been launched under one district, one product brands under Pradhan Mantri Formalization of Micro Food Processing Enterprises? This we have discussed in PIB 247 sessions. You don't have to remember the name of all the six brands. Just remember, six brands were launched and the target is to launch 10 brands, out of which recently six brands were launched under PM Formalization of Micro Food Processing Enterprises scheme. 271. Kisan Sampada Yojana, which is an umbrella scheme of the Ministry of Food Processing Enterprises, which consists of various schemes like Mega Food Park scheme and others, by Ministry of Food Processing Industry to provide a big boost to the growth of food processing sector in the country. When was the scheme launched? Can you identify the launch year of the scheme, guys? When was the scheme launched? So remember, it was launched in the year 2016. Option C will be the correct answer. And please don't get confused. The implementing ministries of Ministry of Food Processing and Industry and not the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare. 272. Ministry of Food Processing Industry again has been implementing Mega Food Park scheme since the year 2008. Very important. Do remember the launch year of Mega Food Park scheme, which is now a component of Pradhan Mantri Kisan Sampada Yojana, as I already told you. The primary objective of the scheme is to provide modern infrastructure facilities for the food processing. How much percent of eligible project cost is provided as grant in aid? Remember, under this scheme, 50% of the eligible project cost is provided as grant in aid in normal areas, while in the hard to reach areas or the difficult areas, 50% or rupees 50 crore. Okay, up to 50 crore, not up or 50% up to rupees 50 crores. And in case of difficult areas, it is 75% or up to rupees 50 crores. Okay, 75% up to rupees 50 crores. And remember, under this scheme, Mega Food Park scheme, as on 5th April 2022, as per Press Information Bureau, 41 Mega Food Parks were approved, and out of which 22 are in operation. 22 are operational, 41 are have been approved. And recently, a Mega Food Park has been approved in Muzaffarpur of Bihar. So here, they haven't mentioned that whether it is the question is regarding the normal area or the hard to reach places. So in this case, you would consider the question is regarding the normal areas. So therefore, the correct answer will be what? Option D, 50%. And how many Mega Food Parks have been approved by the Ministry of Food Processing Industry? It is 41. Option B will be the correct answer. It is a central sector scheme aimed at infrastructure development to rejuvenate the pilgrimage destinations and to enrich the tourist experience and to enhance the employment opportunities in these areas. When was the scheme launched? First of all, can you identify this scheme? Yes, it is Prasad scheme. It is Prasad scheme. पहले प्रसाद बोलते थे, फिर प्रसाद बोलने लगे. I don't know what they are doing, but yes, Prasad is the name of the scheme. And it was launched in 2014-15. Option A will be the correct answer to this question. All right. 275. How many thematic areas were identified by Ministry of Tourism under Swadesh Darshan scheme, which was also launched in the year 2014-15 along with Prasad scheme? Prasad scheme ko bhi launch kiya gaya tha. Now, who is the Minister of Tourism, by the way? It's Mr. G. Kishan Reddy. He is also the Minister of Culture and Minister of Development of Northeastern Region. And under Swadesh Darshan scheme, there are 15 thematic circuits. Option E will be the correct answer, guys, to this question. All right. And now 25 questions are over. So I hope aapko ye session acha lag raha hoga, because the session is not live today. So I am not here to take your doubts. But yes, abhi bhi aap apne comment section mein live pooch sakte ho, because jab ye primer chal raha hai, to I will reply to your comments as well. But agar usme agar reply nahi ho paata hai, to in that case, you can ask your doubts in the comment section after completion of session. All right. And yes, jo agla session hoga, main fir se bata deta hoon. Agla session hoga, that is from 301 to 350, and that session is on Wednesday. So in that session, I am going to take 50 questions from any scheme. Jo bhi bach gayi hai ab ministry, jitni bhi bach gayi hai, unme se main best 50 questions uthane wala hoon, theek hai? And in the next, that is from 350 to 400, we are going to do the schemes which were in news in the month of March and April. Theek hai? March aur April mein jo bhi schemes news mein thi, because the earlier two sessions of schemes in news were up to the month of February 2022. ठीक है? So, but we have to do the scheme from which were in news in the month of March and April as well. So that's why question number 351 to 400, all the questions will be from the schemes which were in news in the month of March and April 2022. So please mind this. All right. देखो time table में change तो करना ही पड़ता है. इसको हम थोड़ा सा improvisation बोलते हैं, because 400 क्वेश्चन जो हमने वो टाइम टेबल डिस्कस किया था, उसमें 400 क्वेश्चन की बात करी थी. 400 क्वेश्चन आपको पूरे हो जाएंगे, डोंट वरी. ठीक है? बट मैं ये नहीं चाहता कि अननेसेसरी में जबरदस्ती 400 क्वेश्चन आपको कराऊं, राइट? क्योंकि अब मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ टूरिज्म में, मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एनवायरमेंट में, मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ ये आपकी न्यू एंड रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी में, देर आर वेरियस स्कीम्स विच आर एब्सोल्युटली नॉट इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर एग्जाम. सो इंक्लूडिंग क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम दो स्कीम्स विल ओनली वेस्ट योर टाइम, एंड आई डोंट रियली वॉन्ट दैट. ऑलराइट. 276. It is an initiative of Ministry of Tourism in collaboration with the Ministry of Culture and Archaeological Survey of India. It entails encouraging students, public sector and private organizations under their CSR funds to participate more actively in the maintenance of Indian heritage. When was the initiative launched? First of all, can you identify the scheme? It is Adopt a Heritage. It is Adopt a Heritage. And remember one thing here. No fund is provided by Ministry of Tourism or the central government. कोई fund इसमें नहीं दिया जाता है. ये basically ये एक awareness generation program है, जिसमें कि students को, public sector को और private organization को aware करती है सरकार कि you guys should adopt a heritage and develop it. ठीक है? As a matter of duty towards the nation. And remember, it was launched in 2014. Option C. To increase the tribal income by value addition of tribal products. And yes, Ministry of Tribal Affairs is also there today. Ministry of Tribal Affairs is headed by Mr. Arjun Singh Munda. His Lok Sabha constituency is Khunti, Jharkhand. Khunti is the place where the great Birsa Munda born. So to increase the tribal income by value addition of tribal products, Vandhan Yojana was launched by Ministry of Tribal Affairs in 2018. Which of the following is the nodal implementing agency for the scheme? Remember, it is a central sector scheme and rupees 15 lakh per Vandhan Vikas Kendras. Under this scheme, Vandhan Vikas Kendras are being established. 15 lakh per 300 membered Vandhan Vikas Kendras is provided by TRIFED. Okay? And therefore, the implementing agency for this scheme is TRIFED. Option A will be the correct answer. Question number 278. How much amount is provided by TRIFED to each 300 member Vandhan Vikas Kendra? So, as I already told you, it is option B, rupees 15 lakh. Identify the scheme launched in 2014 for the holistic development and welfare of tribal population in India by plugging the infrastructure gaps and lags in human development indices. Alright. सो वेरी इजी क्वेश्चन. इट वॉज वन धन वन बंधु कल्याण योजना, नॉट ए, इट इज सी, वन बंधु कल्याण योजना. ऑप्शन सी विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर. इट वॉज लॉन्च फॉर होलिस्टिक डेवलपमेंट एंड वेलफेयर ऑफ ट्राइबल पॉपुलेशन इन इंडिया. ऑलराइट, ऑप्शन सी विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर. 280-281. Read the following passage and you have to answer the questions that follow. To increase the literacy level among the tribals of India by imparting quality education to children of scheduled tribes, a scheme is being implemented by Ministry of Tribal Affairs since 1997-1998. I believe you have identified this scheme. Because I have identified this scheme, it is Eklavya Model Residential School. The objective of the scheme is being achieved by constructing world-class schools for tribal students on the lines of Navodaya Vidyalaya. By 2022, every block with more than 50% ST population and at least 20,000 tribal persons will have a world-class school for tribals. So as I already told you, it is Eklavya Model Residential School. And recently, the financial assistance for constructing an EMRS was enhanced to 38 crores in normal areas and to 48 crores in northeastern and hilly areas. 5 crore rupees is provided for upgradation of any school from a normal school to EMRS. And rupees 1,09,000 per student is provided by the government of India. Alright, so let's come to the question then. How much amount is provided for constructing a school in northeastern hilly and difficult areas? So remember, it is 48 crores, option A. And which of the following statements is incorrect with respect to the scheme? Admissions are taken through competitive process. This is absolutely correct. Number of seats for boys and girls are equal. Yes, this is also correct. Do remember this. This is very important fact. There is no such reservation which is provided to the girls. Total sanctioned strength of the school is 480. Bilkul sahi hai. Education in the school is entirely free. So all are correct, which means option E, none is incorrect, will be the correct answer. 282 पे आ जाते हैं. इन पार्टनरशिप विद विच आईआईटी अ कैपेसिटी बिल्डिंग एंड एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप स्किल ट्रेनिंग प्रोग्राम हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड फॉर ट्राइबल फॉरेस्ट प्रोड्यूस गैदरर्स एनरोल्ड अंडर द प्रधानमंत्री वंदन योजना. ओके, सो रिमेंबर, दिस इनिशिएटिव वाज लॉन्च्ड इन 2020 इन कोलैबोरेशन विद आईआईटी कानपुर. द नेम ऑफ द इनिशिएटिव इज टेक फॉर ट्राइबल्स. इट इज टेक फॉर ट्राइबल्स एंड यस, देयरफॉर द करेक्ट आंसर इज व्हाट, ऑप्शन सी, आईआईटी कानपुर. 283-285, again there is a passage. To bring about blue revolution through sustainable and responsible development of fisheries sector in India, a scheme was launched by Ministry of Fisheries. The scheme intends to augment the fish production and productivity at an annual growth rate of 9% to achieve a target of 22 million metric tons by 2024-25. It also aims to double the incomes of fishers, fish farmers and fish workers by 2024. Now, can you identify this scheme? Yes, that's Pradhan Mantri Matsya Sampada Yojana. Very easy. Pradhan Mantri Matsya Sampada Yojana is the name of the scheme and it is being implemented, of course, by Ministry of Fisheries Animal Husbandry, which is headed by Mr. I'm forgetting the name of the Minister of Fisheries. Purushottam Rupala. Yes, it is Purushottam Rupala. All right, so it is Pradhan Mantri Matsya Sampada Yojana. And let's come to the question. What is the total estimated investment of the scheme? It is 20,050 crores. Option D will be the correct answer. Very easy question. Bahut baar idhar udhar pucha ja chuka hai. Under the scheme mentioned in the passage, a river ranching program has been launched in 5 states. Which of the following is not among those 5 states? Theek hai? So can you identify these 5 states? It is UP, Odisha, Uttarakhand, Tripura and Chhattisgarh. And Chhattisgarh, Madhya Pradesh is the correct answer, guys, to this question. And what is the target of export earning in fisheries sector under the scheme mentioned in the passage? So it is 1 lakh crore. ठीक है, 1 lakh crore का target है in the is the export target in this sector, in this fisheries sector under this particular scheme. And let me tell you about the that funding pattern of this scheme. इसके अब हम funding pattern की बात कर लेते हैं थोड़ा सा. One second. Yes, यहाँ पे लिख देते हैं. थोड़ा सा डिफिकल्ट है इसका फंडिंग पैटर्न. सो रिमेंबर, देर आर टू कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ दिस स्कीम. वन इज सेंट्रल सेक्टर, वन इज सेंट्रली स्पॉन्सर्ड. एंड देर आर टू सब कंपोनेंट्स. वन इज नॉन बेनिफिशियरी एंड वन इज बेनिफिशियरी. in the centrally sponsored as well, there are two subcomponents, non-beneficiary, and again there is beneficiary. In the case of central sector, non-beneficiary ke case mein 100% funding is provided by the central government. In the case of beneficiary subcomponent, 40% in the case of unreserved of the general entrepreneurs or the farmers or the fishermen, 60% in the case of women SC or ST entrepreneurs. ठीक है, this 40% is provided by central government and the rest will be borne by the beneficiary, and 60% in case of SC ST or women beneficiary. अब centrally sponsored की अगर हम बात करें तो in the case of non-beneficiary the funding will be borne by the central government and the respective state government in the ratio of 60-40 in the case of normal states, while in the case of northeastern and Himalayan state it is 90-10, and in the non-beneficiary in the beneficiary oriented again 40% in case of unreserved or general entrepreneurs, in case of 40% in case of SC ST or women entrepreneurs, this 40% is shared between center and state in this ratio 60-40 in case of normal state, 90-10 in the case of northeastern or Himalayan state. So I believe you guys have got my point. And NIFTEM and IIFPT, NIFTEM, which is National Institute of Food Technology, Entrepreneurship and Management, and Indian Institute of Food Processing Technology is the implementing agency for this scheme. Guys, one second, please, if you can hold this. Yes, I hope this is clear. One second, guys. There is some issue with this. All right, so I hope this funding pattern is clear. And rupees 1 lakh crore is the correct answer. All right. And NIFTEM and IIFPT are not the capacity building things here. NIFTEM and IIFPT are for this scheme, which we have Prime Minister's formalization of micro food processing enterprises, jo scheme tha, usme main aapko ek baat batani bhul gaya, okay. Let me come to that scheme. Okay, chalo main yahi bata deta hu, no problems. In Prime Minister formalization of micro food processing enterprises scheme, NIFTEM and IIFPT are the institutes responsible for capacity building and research. Thoda sa confusion tha wahan pe. NIFTEM is National Institute of Food Technology, Entrepreneurship and Management, which is located in Sonipat, and IIFPT, it is Indian Institute of Food Processing Technology, which is located in Tanjavur, Tanjavur. All right, so question number 285, option A, 1 lakh crore is the correct answer. यहाँ पे mistake था, NIFTEM and IIFPT नहीं है, थोड़ा सा confusion हो गया था यहाँ पे. 286 पे आ जाते हैं. The Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs had approved implementation of special livestock sector package consisting of several activities by revising and realigning various components of Government of India schemes for next 5 years, starting from 2021-22. How much amount central government will provide for leveraging the total investment of 54,618 crores for a period of 5 years? So basically, they are just asking what is the corpus of special livestock sector package. So that is 9,800 crore. बस ये question को लंबा कर दिया है unnecessary, just to waste your time. तो आपको इसीलिए you guys have to identify the keywords in the passage and फटाफट से आपको identify कर लेना है that yes, this is the this would be the answer to this question. 9,800 crores is the correct answer. Dairy processing and infrastructure development fund की बात हो रही है, सीधा question पे आ जाओ, what is the total outlay of the fund? बीच की चीजों को पढ़ने की जरूरत ही नहीं है. Total outlay of the dairy processing and infrastructure development fund is 11,184 crores. Option A will be the correct answer. 288, with the objective of increasing of milk and meat processing capacity and product diversification, animal husbandry infrastructure development fund was launched as a part of Atmanirbhar Bharat package. What is the total outlay of the fund? Again, very easy question. मैंने बहुत बार discuss किया हुआ ये question. I will not waste any time on this. It is 15,000 crore, which is the funding, which is the total corpus of animal husbandry infrastructure development fund. And yes, Ministry of Communication is also there today. क्योंकि देखो मैंने पहले भी बताया मैं अननेसेसरी की स्कीम्स नहीं लेके आऊंगा, सिर्फ वही लेके आऊंगा जो कि इंपॉर्टेंट है। भारत नेट प्रोजेक्ट इज द वर्ल्ड्स लार्जेस्ट रूरल ब्रॉडबैंड कनेक्टिविटी प्रोग्राम यूजिंग ऑप्टिकल फाइबर। नेशनल ऑप्टिकल फाइबर नेटवर्क वॉज लॉन्च इन 2011। इट वॉज रीनेम्ड एज भारत नेट प्रोजेक्ट इन 2015। द एंटायर प्रोजेक्ट इज बींग फंडेड बाई USOF, विच इज यूनिवर्सल सर्विस ऑब्लिगेशन फंड। दिस फंड इज मैनेज बाई डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ टेलीकम्युनिकेशन and this fund is being came into force in the year 2002, remember this, which was set up for improving telecom services in rural and remote areas of the country. Which of the following is the implementing agency of the BharatNet project? Very easy question, it is Bharat Broadband Network Limited. Option D will be the correct answer. In how many states Union Cabinet has approved a viability gap funding support of up to ₹19,041 crore for the implementation of BharatNet project टू द पब्लिक प्राइवेट पार्टनरशिप मॉडल? कितने स्टेट्स में यूनियन कैबिनेट ने अप्रूव किया है वायबिलिटी गैप फंडिंग सपोर्ट अप टू ₹19,041 crore फॉर द इम्प्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ भारत नेट प्रोजेक्ट थ्रू द पब्लिक प्राइवेट पार्टनरशिप मॉडल? रिमेंबर इट इज 16, ऑप्शन बी 16 स्टेट्स इज द करेक्ट आंसर। 291 इज द क्वेश्चन ऑन USOF। इट इज अ नॉन लैप्सिबल फंड जनरेटेड बाय 5% यूनिवर्सल सर्विस लेवाई that is charged upon all the telecom fund operators on their adjusted gross revenue. This fund is used to extend the telecom network and to stimulate the uptake of internet and communication technology services. Question is, in which year it came into force? So I have just told you it was launched in the year 2002. Option A will be the correct answer. The scheme aims at protecting, restoring and enhancing India's diminishing forest cover and responding to climate change. It is also aimed at increasing forest cover to the extent of 5 million hectares and improve the quality of forest cover on another 5 million hectare of forest or non-forest lands. Can you identify the scheme? I have identified the scheme. It is National Mission on Green India. National Mission on Green India. ठीक है ना? It was launched in 2014 with the total outlay of 46,000 crores. Option D will be the correct answer. 293, for development of skills in the field of environment and forest sector to enable India's youth to get gainful employment, Green Skill Development Program was launched by Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, which is headed by Mr. Bhupendra Yadav. When was the scheme launched? So remember, it was launched in the year 2017. Option B will be the correct answer. It is Green Skill Development Program, launched in 2017. 294, name the web-based single window integrated system for environment, forest, wildlife and CRZ clearance processes. It is an integrated environmental management system launched on the occasion of World Biofuel Day, that is on 10th of August 2018. Very easy question, this single window integrated system is named as Parivesh. Option C will be the correct answer. 295, National Action Plan on Climate Change was launched in 2008. This plan aims to enable the country to adapt to climate change and enhance the ecological sustainability of India's development path. The plan consists of 8 sub-schemes. Which of the following is not? So National Solar Mission is there, Water Mission is there, Hydrogen Mission is not there, National Mission for Green India is there, National Mission for Sustainable Agriculture is there. Now let me ask you a question today, because main kabhi question nahi poochta generally, but let me ask you a question today. Which are the other 4 sub-schemes? Write down in the comments. So here the correct answer will be National Hydrogen Mission, option C. For effective abatement of pollution, conservation and rejuvenation of River Ganga, okay, Ministry of Jal Shakti is also there. A scheme was launched by Ministry of Jal Shakti in 2014. Chacha Chaudhary has recently become the brand ambassador of this scheme. What is the total outlay of the scheme? So agar aapne is scheme ko revise bhi nahi kiya na, only then you would be easily, you can easily answer this question, guys. इट इज नमामि गंगे प्रोग्राम, चाचा चौधरी से ही ये बात क्लियर हो गई ना। इट इज नमामि गंगे प्रोग्राम विच वॉज लॉन्च इन 2014 एंड द टोटल आउटले फॉर दिस इज 20,000 crores। ऑप्शन ए विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर। विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट इज इनकरेक्ट विद रिस्पेक्ट टू डैम रिहेबिलिटेशन एंड इम्प्रूवमेंट प्रोजेक्ट? नाउ दिस मैसेज विच आई एम टेलिंग नाउ इज फॉर द एनरोल्ड स्टूडेंट। रिमेंबर इन द PDF ओनली वर्ल्ड बैंक इज मेंशन्ड दैट इट इज बीइंग फंडेड बाय द वर्ल्ड बैंक, बट रिमेंबर नाउ देयर इज एशियन इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर इन्वेस्टमेंट बैंक एज वेल। ओके, सो प्लीज मार्क दिस करेक्शन। Its phase one was launched in 2012 for a period up to 2018. बिल्कुल सही बात है. Phases 2 and 3 have been launched in 2020 for a 10 years period. बिल्कुल सही है. In phase 2 and 3, ₹10,211 crore is the total budget and the PDF. Earlier they have mentioned 10,200 crore. Now they are saying 10,211 crore. I don't know what they want to do. So yes, to 10,211 crore. And in the PDF also it is mentioned 2,200 crore. So please again mark this correction. And external funding is provided by World Bank and not ADB, it is AIIB. Okay. And the scheme envisages rehabilitation and safety improvement of 736 dams located in 19 states. So we have to identify the incorrect statements, which means option D will be the correct answer, guys, to this question. And 298, Swachh Bharat Mission Grameen Phase 2, very easy question. The question is, what is the total outlay of the scheme? Okay, so it is 14881 crores. Option A will be the correct answer to this question. Okay, so is tarike se aapko pehle aapne identify kar liya, uske baad ye sari cheeze beech wali padhne ki zarurat nahi hai, last mein seedha question pe aa jao aur jaldi se mark karo aur aage badho. All right, please don't waste your time. 299, to recharge ground water sources and revive surface water bodies by involving people at the local level, Atal Bhujal Yojana was launched in 2019. It is a central sector scheme supported by World Bank and the total outlay of the scheme is 6,000 crore, out of which 50%, that is 3,000 crore, is provided by World Bank. And that is the question only. Therefore, the correct answer will be what? Option B, 3,000 crore. And the last question for today is based on Jal Jeevan Mission, was announced in 2019 with an objective to provide functional household tap connection to every household, with service level at the rate of 55 liters per capita per day. Very easy scheme. It is being implemented by Ministry of Jal Shakti, which is headed by Gajendra Singh Shekhawat. Lok Sabha constituency is Jodhpur, which is of course in Jharkhand. And what is the total outlay of Jal Jeevan Mission? By the way, it is 3.60 lakh crores. Option D will be the correct answer. All right. And guys, that's it for today's session. I hope all these schemes are clear. एक जगह पे थोड़ी सी confusion हुई थी. I beg your pardon for that, because हो जाता है कभी कभी, ठीक है ना. And I hope you guys are revising everything and revise करते रहो, because please don't lose out the time. And remember, एक चीज याद रखना, जो match है, जो अगर cricket match की अगर मैं बात करता हूँ, तो cricket match जो है ना, अगर मैं T20 की बात करूं तो लास्ट के 5 ओवर में डिसाइड होते हैं मोस्ट ऑफ द मैचेस. अगर कोई वन साइडेड मैच है तो कोई बात नहीं कर सकते. जब व्हेन देयर इज अ यू नो कट थ्रोट कंपटीशन बिटवीन एनी टू टीम्स, देन ऐसा देखा जाता है दैट मोस्ट ऑफ द मैचेस आर डिसाइडेड इन द लास्ट फ्यू ओवर्स. एंड दैट इज द केस विद द कॉम्पिटिटिव एग्जामिनेशन एज वेल, बिकॉज देयर इज अ वेरी कट थ्रोट कॉम्पिटिशन. सो एवरीथिंग इज डिसाइडेड इन द लास्ट 1 month और 20 days ऑफ द एग्जामिनेशन. हाउ यू नो कितनी डेस्परेटली, तो मैं नहीं बोलूंगा डेस्परेटली, थोड़ा सा नेगेटिव वर्ड है, हाउ एफिशियंटली यू आर रिवाइजिंग, ठीक है, दैट डिपेंड्स ऑन इट. योर सिलेक्शन डिपेंड्स ऑन द लास्ट 20 days और 30 days ऑफ बिफोर योर एग्जामिनेशन. सो प्लीज डोंट लूज आउट योर टाइम, प्लीज डोंट लूज आउट योर होप, जस्ट गिव योर बेस्ट शॉट दिस टाइम टू दिस एग्जामिनेशन. एंड थैंक यू सो मच फॉर वॉचिंग. आई विल सी यू इन द नेक्स्ट सेशन ऑन वेडनेसडे. In that session, we are going to do another 50 questions from various government schemes, jo ki ab bach gayi hain. All right, thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, Jai Hind, Jai Bharat, and God bless.